إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. جزاكم الله خيرا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمد عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد, always and forever we begin with the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send our prayers of peace upon our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we testify with firmness and conviction that none is worthy of worship but Allah, and that our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his worshipping slave and final messenger. I always remind myself and you of taqwallah azza wa jalla. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants you and I an inner consciousness and piety of heart that is greater in our privacy than what we seek to show each other publicly. Allahumma ameen. One of the greatest skills demonstrated and taught by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to his companions was the ability to redeem oneself. And the concept of tawbah is very unique to the people of Islam. And when you look at the faith of people who have practiced scriptures and traditions that came before our Quran, that we as Muslims believe have strayed away from the light that was sent initially by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the themes that you see our deen and our submission and surrender to Allah is at odds and in contrast to theirs. Although they have a belief in the divine and in monotheism in its general capacity, is the concept of redemption and repentance. So if you were to look at the Judeo-Christian context, the ability to fix one's sins between oneself and God always involves a proxy or another individual. So a Catholic will attend to church and will provide confession to a priest, to somebody that they will divulge their mistakes in hope that that person will give them a cure and a remedy for their error. In fact, within Catholicism, the petition that is direct to God is very limited. What you will find is that they will make articles and statements such as the Hail Mary, where they will call out to Mary, who they believe is the mother of, أعوذ بالله من ذلك, the Lord, who they refer to as Isa alayhi salam. And they will say, forgive us our sins, meaning ask your son, who they believe is the one who forgives sins, to forgive us. Because we are unclean, we cannot ask God directly. The Jewish tradition is very different in that regard. They believe that repentance and redemption can only be done through acts of sacrifice and atonements, and that there are only specific days or specific times and specific ceremonies where it can be carried out. And one can contend, when you study some of their theology, that it is nearly impossible for an independent Jewish person to ask God for forgiveness independently. And then came the sunnah of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the light that shines in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. When they ask you about me, O Muhammad, and that is in the context of redemption and repentance. It's in the same set of verses that ends the sequence of verses about Siyam. When they ask you about how to approach me, where to find me, don't be in the middle between me and them. فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. I'm near them. Doesn't involve you. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, some of the most bewildering hadith, you will always find that the Prophet would distance people from himself and turn them back to Allah Azza wa Jal. A famous incident is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari where a man comes in a similar day and time that we are today. And as the Prophet is entering to lead the jama'ah, the sahaba in prayer, a man stops him and says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَدْ قَبَّلْتُ إِمْرَأَ I was kissing and involved in sexual contact with a woman who's not my wife. And the Prophet pushes him away and said, دَعْنَا مِنْ هَذَا This isn't the time to speak to me about this. دَعْنَا نُصَلِّي Let us pray. And the man steps back and the Prophet leads the prayer. And after the Prophet finishes the salah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he does something uncharacteristic, which is he gets up and begins to leave quickly. Normally he would stay and make some of the adhkar and answer questions and so on. This man from a distance sees the Prophet ﷺ attempting to escape him. So he runs to the Messenger ﷺ and says, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah. And the Prophet ﷺ said, Da'na min hadha, alam tusalli ma'ana? Stop. Didn't you just pray? The man says, yes. Didn't you ask for forgiveness? The man says, yes. So the Prophet says to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ma min mu'minin. This is usually the hadith you and I know. We only know the ending of it. We don't know the story of how it began. Sometimes people are shy to give you the fact that one of the sahaba did something which is sinful. But this is recorded in our tradition, although he may not be named in other traditions he is. Although he may not be named, it shows you the importance of taking ownership and confronting ourselves. And the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا مِن مُؤْمِنٍ There isn't any believer who makes أَسْبَغَ الْوُضُوء who makes a good wudu, makes a good ablution, and prays to Allah, even if it is only two rak'ah, even if it's just two rak'ah to Allah. ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهِ Then that person asks Allah, إِلَّا غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهِ Except that Allah forgives them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, of course, don't write this hadith down and say, MashaAllah, I'm going to make a lot of salah now. I can go do whatever I want and salah wallahu ghafoor raheem. Could you imagine the courage it would take to come to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and declare a mistake you made knowing he can hold you punishable? His tawbah was already genuine between him and Allah, and the Prophet reinforces it. Today I want to speak about the psychology of redemption, how you and I prepare ourselves to redeem ourselves. Just three important steps taken from the Sunnah of the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The first of them is referred to as self-confrontation. And this is, you know, if you were to study psychology, it's very, very similar to how do you redeem yourself if you've wronged someone? How do you fix a mistake? How do you move on in life? How do you heal yourself and others after a tragedy, after a harm, after a folly that you have made? And this was taught to us by the Prophet ﷺ in numerous instances, summarized into three steps. The first is self-confrontation. We call this in our deen, in our tazkiyah studies, al-muhasaba. Umar radiallahu anhu would say on the minbar in khutbat al-jumu'ah, حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُوا Examine yourself. Take stock, account, confront yourself before Allah will confront you. زِنُوهَا قَبْلَ أَن تُوزَن Weigh your deeds out before they will be weighed for you by Allah. تَهَيَّأُوا لِلْعَرْضِ الْأَكْبَرِ Imagine the day of public shame and display. يَوْمَ تُبْلَى الصَّرَائِرِ When none of your secrets will be hidden. Self-confrontation is the first step to redemption, the first step to tawbah. And Allah invites you and I to tawbah as believers, not as sinners. Allah never in the Quran, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا Never Allah says, Oh you who believe, you criminals. Oh you criminals, tubu ila Allah. It's, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا The pretext of repentance is faith. And the pretext of faith is repentance. And the ulama, they speak about the three important cycles. عِلْم فَتَوْبَ فَمُجَاهَدَ Knowledge, so I know what I do right and wrong. When I identify through knowledge, this is wrong. عَلَى بَصِيرَ أَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَرْجَعُ عَنْهَا I confront myself, hey, I shouldn't be doing this. Then I have to kick in my jihad nafs against myself. And the mujahada makes me a better person, so I learn more, so it makes me repent more. And the more you repent, the more your iman grows, the more your iman grows, the more you repent from bigger sins until you find the smaller indiscretions in your life. Self-examination, self-confrontation is an essential step for all of us. Usually we wait until confronted by others. You know, somebody jacks you up, somebody pulls you, hey, what are you doing? What's wrong with you? How come you didn't? To do it for yourself is an act of ibadah, an act of iman, it is muhasabah. But once you've identified your fault and you've examined your circumstance, it then requires the second step taught to us through the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, which is self-regulation, self-control. That you begin to regulate your own patterns of behavior. You begin to think about the halal and haram and the sunnah and the bid'ah and the good and the bad and the what I should do more of and what? Why haven't I done more of this good even though I have the opportunity? Why have I done this wrong? Why haven't I limited this wrong? And why haven't I chosen to do something wrong that's lesser wrong than another? So now you begin to control and look within your heart about what you've confronted in your own self. As you look into the mirror, you recognize your follies and you say, I am responsible. Shaitan, of course, is the opposite. So Allah gives us that example early on in the Quran. As soon as you open the Mus'haf, Surah Al-Fatiha, the first story you hear is Adam and the Shaitan. Wa ya Adam. Adam, don't eat from this tree. Shaitan, before him, Allah tests him and he fails. Usjudu li Adam, fasajadu illa Iblis, except Iblis. Iblis, when is asked, why? لِمَ لَا تَسْجُدُ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْهِ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِنْ I'm better. At the end of it, of course, Iblis blames Allah and not himself. قَالَ بِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي Because you gave me the ability to make the mistake, it's your fault, not my fault. بِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي You allowed me to be led astray, Ya Allah. Why did you create me not like Jibreel, not like Mikael, not like Israfil, that I'm angelic? Why did you give me the capacity to choose? It's your fault, Ya Allah. And therefore the self-control, the self-regulation, the taking ownership of one's mistake, self-confrontation is missing from the aqidah of Iblis. In fact, when you study our aqidah, this is called al-aqidah al-iblisiyah. It is a part of the deviant sects within Islam in how they view qadr, fate, predestiny. That God is the one who allows you to do wrong, it's not entirely your fault. Iblis blames Allah. But you see the opposite with Adam. قَالَ آدَمْ and Hawa, رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنْ خَاسِرِينَ Oh Allah, we wronged ourselves. We admit our mistakes. Allahumma inni zalamtu nafsi zulman kathira. Look at the dua of them. Oh Allah, I wronged myself. Zalamu anfusahum. Allah says they wronged themselves. They chose. And therefore self-control becomes the amana that Allah provided humanity. What separates between you and I and the animals? We are animals in our biological sense. What separates you from the animals that are around us in our rationale and our spirit is that we recognize that we have an amana that we fulfill in maintaining a duty unto God and societies that we live in. Self-regulation comes after self-confrontation. After Izzatul Israha, we'll speak of the last of the important steps for us to begin a pathway towards redemption. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ الحمد لله حمد الشاكرين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا ومصطفانا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Self-confrontation, taking stock of yourself, knowing your positives, knowing your negatives, being willing to confront yourself, willing to admit. Self-control and regulation becomes the necessary step for you to take a step towards good. And the Prophet ﷺ says in the hadith of Imam Muslim that the one who takes one step towards Allah, Allah returns it to him 10 steps. And the one who walks towards God, Allah runs in anticipation of him, hurries him towards him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a tawbah that is sincere and nasuh before our return to Allah. The third step is self-sacrifice. Self-confrontation, self-regulation and control, and then giving of yourself. What's the best way to fix a mistake is that you do something for others, subhanAllah. Because whenever you air fault with yourself and others, you've taken what doesn't belong. You've taken from someone's time, someone's wealth, someone's energy, someone's heart, someone's love, someone's emotion. You've wasted that which is precious. And for you to fix it, you must give of yourself. And that's the height of attaining righteousness. لَن تَنَالُ الْبِرْ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُ مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You do not attain a level of piety, of righteousness, until you can part and give from the things you value. لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى يُحِبُّ لِأَخِيهِ مَا يُحِبُّهُ لِنَفْسِهِ. How can you come to be complete of faith until the things you value them for the other? So you wasted somebody else's time, give of your time to others. You borrowed but did not return, give in charity in the name of the one you took from. Find within you the capacity to serve and not be served, to give and not just receive, to help and not just request, to be a person who is in credit with others, not in debit, that you are providing more than taking. And such was the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you were to sum up the life of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the greatest achievements of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was that he gave selflessly of his advice, of his love, of his dua, to the point that the Prophet prefers you and your akhirah to the luxury of himself in the dunya. And I end with this hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِن نَبِي. There isn't a single prophet, a single messenger, except Allah has given them the authority, the ability to make da'wah, a dua for themselves, that Allah will answer it unquestioned. فَدَعَ بِهَا النَّبِيُّونَ. All of the prophets before me, they made their dua. Ibrahim asked, Musa asked, all of them asked for what they wanted. إِلَّا أَنَا sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Except me, اِخْتَبَتُ دَعْوَتِي. I hid it, I held it close into my heart. اِخْتَبَتُ دَعْوَتِي شَفَاعَةَ أُمَّتِي. So that I can speak on behalf of my ummah on the day of judgment, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What greater sacrifice, what greater love for the other than your Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And therefore be prepared to know that each and every one of us, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كُلُّ ابْنِ آدَمَ خَطَّاءٌ. Every human being has their capacity and their errors in life. Everyone. Everyone has their mistakes. وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. But the best of those human beings who are making mistakes are those who return back to Allah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our heart, to confront our souls, ourselves, in that which we have wronged and erred. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to develop self-control and self-regulation, that we are responsible to Allah more than we are to others. That we do what's right for the sake of what's right, not for the praise of others, and we stay away from what's wrong, not because we're observed and fearful of the shame, but because we know what is right and what is wrong and what is pleasing to Allah and what isn't. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to be from those who give of their energy and time and devotion to others. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to be يُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا. That we give even from what we need. اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين واخذ الأعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم اهدنا واهدهم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على حبيبنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وأقم الصلاة. اللهم صل على رسول الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا لا إله إلا الله Humble yourselves to Allah عز وجل اخشعوا في صلاتكم صلوا صلاة مودع Consider this may be one of our last prayers الله أكبر سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك تبارك اسمك لا إله إلا أعوذ بالله السميع العليم الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان. إنما إلهكم الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الذي لا إله إلا هو واسع كل شيء علما كذلك نقص عليك من أنباء ما قد سبق وقد آتيناك من لدنا ذكرا من أعرض عنه فإنه يحمل يوم القيامة وزرا خالدين فيه وساء لهم يوم القيامة حملا يوم ينفخ في الصور ونحشر المجرمين يومئذ زرقا يتخافتون بينهم إن لبثتم إلا عشرا نحن أعلم بما يقولون إذ يقول أمثلهم طريقة إن لبثتم إلا يوما ويسألونك عن الجبال فقل ينسفها ربي نسفا الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ويسألونك عن الجبال فقل ينسفها ربي نسفا فيذرها قاعا صفصفا لا ترى فيها عوجا ولا أمتا يومئذ يتبعون الداعي لا عوج له وخشعت الأصوات للرحمن فلا تسمع إلا همسا
يومئذ لا تنفع الشفاعة إلا من أذن له الرحمن ورضي له قولا يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون به علما وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله